9th fret of the D string, go. Move it down to the 6th fret. 2nd fret. Back up to the 9th. So B. G sharp. Motif that sits at the top there. it's E on the high E string, which is the 12th fret. E flat or D sharp, which is the 11th. Back up to the E, down to B, which is the 12th fret of the B string. E, high E. And repeat that again. That's that. The little motif that runs under the verse is basically a two finger exercise. Take the 7th fret on the high E, which is the note of B, and the 9th fret on the B string, which is the note of G sharp. What you're going to do is you're just going to alternate. Once you've done that, go for 9th fret on both, which is C sharp and G sharp. Then open up the high E and keep the 9th fret on the B string, the G sharp note. Back to the 7th fret. Do that as an alternate picking thing, it'll keep you in time. And then the little chorus thing. Four of those. 11th fret, 12th fret on the B, 13th fret on the G, which is the note of G sharp. Repeat. Then take this G sharp note, which is the 13th fret on the G string, bend it a semitone. That riff, then we've got the sort of the bridge middle bit and the outro riff, which is going to be an E power chord, then we have an inverted B, which is going to be the 6th fret on the A string. Well, okay, so the E was the 7th fret on the A string, 9th fret on the D, 9th fret on the G. This is going to be the 6th on the A, 9th on the D, 8th on the G. So what's going on there is you've got normal power chord. This finger's going to go back one. This one's going to go back one. That one's going to go on there. If you can't do that, if it's too difficult, you could just take these two. We've just got this riff. Which is the 9th fret or B note on the D string. 6th fret on the G string, which is C sharp. 9th on the G, which is an E. And then the 7th fret on the B string, which is an F sharp. Two of those each time.